Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is actually going to be an extension of last week's topic. And if you didn't watch last week's video, basically I discussed habits, what a habit is, what a habit entails, because it's actually a three-component loop, and how you can use a specific framework that I provide to swap out problematic self-destructive behaviors that you find yourself committing with healthier behaviors that will lead you to have a more abundant, fulfilling life. So if you want to check out that video, I'll link it down below. But in this video, I'm going to niche down this topic into one particular term that I find is beneficial to know, because if you adopt this, then you're going to find that life will be a lot easier for you, because this is a domino effect. And this is known as a keystone habit. So keystone habits are basically small changes that people implement into their routines that unintentionally carry over into other aspects of their lives. So essentially, keystone habits lead to the development of other good, healthy habits. So that's why I kind of referenced the domino effect. They start a chain effect into your life that produces a number of positive outcomes into other areas of your life and other forms of success in other areas of your life. Now, not all keystone habits are positive. Think about what would happen if you decided to eat McDonald's every single day for breakfast. Well, you're gonna notice that you're more foggy mentally, your mental health is gonna suffer, your physical health will suffer too, you'll probably gain some weight, you'll just feel sluggish overall, and this lack of energy could affect your career, it could affect your relationships. So as you can see, it's a domino effect that is leading to a lot of negative outcomes in your life. So it's not always positive. This means that it's important to recognize how one action you commit to on a regular basis influences the larger picture of your life. Because of this, we want to make sure that our everyday actions are leading us to be the better version of ourselves, or if anything, the best version of ourselves, instead of harming us. If you recognize and adopt good keystone habits, you will notice that your life can dramatically improve, all because of one small change. Now, I want to inspire you with a small change that I made in my life that allowed me to experience positive benefits and outcomes in other areas of my life that I wasn't expecting to experience, that I wasn't intending to experience. And this change was me making a TikTok account and uploading every single day. If you don't know, I have a TikTok where I eat organs, and back in March of this year, I decided that I was not gonna miss a day of uploading. I was going to upload an organ-related video every single day and not miss a day. Why? Well, because all the big creators said to do that, all the people who have studied the algorithm and were experts in the TikTok algorithm said to do this, along with using hashtags, trending sounds, you know, and just attention-grabbing little metrics and tricks so that you can gain a following and, you know, have your account grow. So I followed these tips and tricks, I implemented them in my videos, and sure enough, I have gained a pretty good following on that app given the time frame that I have had this account. And yes, I did expect to gain a following. Yes, that happened because I was disciplined in uploading, and so that was expected. But what unintentionally started to happen was that also I grew self-confidence. I was more disciplined with my diet because now I had an audience depending on me to eat healthy. So even though I was healthy with my food choices, or good with my food choices before, this kind of really made me like more disciplined in being healthier. And also I started to now have a new stream of income because of TikTok. I now make money through TikTok. So now it's an additional source of money for me. So not only do I get brand deals and this leads to me getting money in my pocket, but also TikTok, the app itself, pays me. So it unintentionally led to another stream of income, along with unintentionally having me gain confidence and just be a better presenter, I guess. And yeah, it has led also to a good following, which has led me to get brand deals, which again, you know, led me to get money. So I say these things to say that that one small change that I made has affected my life for the better in many ways. And Charles Duhigg, who's the author of this book, The Power of Habits, which is why I'm making these videos, actually echoes this sentiment. He explains that a keystone habit is particularly powerful because it has the ability to really change your self-image for the better. Once you develop and adopt a positive habit, you're more likely to recognize other areas of your life that need improvement and thus create more positive changes in your life. Now, let me give you some more examples of keystone habits that you can adopt if you haven't adopted these habits already. The first one being dressing better. I know there's that famous slogan that goes, don't judge a book by its cover, but the cover gets you to open the book, okay? And humans are very visual creatures, so we judge and we have thoughts about people instantaneously, whether we like it or not. It's just part of our nature, okay? So because the cover gets you to open the book, show up for yourself by dressing really good and dressing nicely, because what you'll notice, if you haven't noticed this already, is that when you dress better and when you dress good, you feel good. And when you feel good, you act more confident. And when you act more confident, people treat you better. Another keystone habit, making your bed every morning. When you make your bed every single morning, it's the first accomplishment of the day. And so that starts a chain reaction of you wanting to accomplish other things within your day. And because it's such an easy task, it kind of sets the momentum for the rest of the day to want to achieve other tasks, since that one was so easy to accomplish, right? You got an instant reward from doing that. And so now you want to seek out more rewards by finishing little tasks. So that's a good one too. Now, another one is exercising. About 2 years ago, I made the commitment to exercise 4 to 5 days a week for 30 minutes each day. And yes, although I look better now physically from making this commitment, also another positive outcome that I've experienced is that I make better food choices, I have increased energy, I have a better mood after I exercise because of the endorphins I get. So there's other benefits that have happened to me that I have experienced because of this small change in my life that I wasn't necessarily intentional on wanting to experience or expecting to experience. And then a last really good keystone habit is meditating. If you adopt meditation in your daily routine, in your daily life, what you're going to notice is that you are going to have reduced levels of anxiety, reduced levels of stress, which is going to allow you to be a better person in your relationships, a better father, a better son, a better daughter, a better friend, etc., because you can actually be present in the moment instead of like just going down this negative spiral, thought spiral in your head, because you took the time out of your day to calm your mind and have inner peace. And so because of those benefits, right, it's going to also impact your career too, if you're in a more peaceful state of mind, because you're going to be able to show up to your job better and actually do what you need to do in a positive way rather than being a negative Nelly. So all of these things, all these positive things come from just that one small change. So that's what I'm really trying to hammer into this video, how one small change can either positively affect your life or negatively affect your life. Because whether you realize it or not, these changes spill over into other areas of your life and can cause you to one day wake up and realize that you're living a pretty good life and that you're grateful and fortunate for all you have, or make you stay in bed all day because you don't want to live the life that you have because you realize you have dug yourself a deep hole and that you're broke, you're sad, you're depressed, you're anxious. So really recognize which routines you're committing to on a daily basis and think to yourself and jot down which ones are giving you the best return on your investment. If you want a framework on that, then please check out my last video on this topic. I'll link it down below. But this was the video for Keystone Habits. This is all I have to say. I hope to see you in my next video. Thanks for watching.